collecting a solid product using vacuum filtration. Vacuum or suction filtration is used to collect a solid product from the solution from which it was crystallized or precipitated. For example, crystals in a recrystallization procedure or a precipitate in some derivatization procedures. In this video, we are going to discuss vacuum filtration. The technique involves six main steps. The first step is to set up the vacuum filtration apparatus. The next step is to collect a solid from mother liquor by vacuum filtration. Then the solid is washed with ice cold solvent in step 3. After that, it is vacuum dried in step 4. If the solid product is completely dry, it can be transferred to a suitable vessel for further analysis in step 5. And if not, the product should be non-vacuum dried using a suitable method. The important thing to remember about the vacuum filtration apparatus assembly is to make sure the filter flask is clamped securely before connecting its side arm to the source of vacuum by means of heavy wall tubing. This can be done either directly or indirectly via a vacuum trap. The trap, for example a second filter flask, may be used to prevent contamination due to back suction. There are three main sources of vacuum. First, there is a water aspirator. While the aspirators are convenient, they waste water and may add loads of volatile solvents into wastewater flows. And in case of a decrease in water pressure, the water can be sucked back into the filtration apparatus. Second, there are chemical resistant pumps and pumping units. Pumping units typically include accessories such as vacuum controller. One pumping unit can be used for two independent vacuum applications simultaneously. And the third is a vacuum line. It's considered to be the most efficient because one vacuum line provides vacuum for multiple uses simultaneously.
First, the tube used for the vacuum needs to have thick walls and be big enough to fit onto the flask. Next, there are different types of filtration funnels, Buchner and Hirsch funnels. Buchner funnels are used for gathering a large amount of solid, whereas Hirsch funnels are used for small amounts. Which one you use will depend on how much solid material you have. Once a funnel is chosen, you will need to secure your vacuum flask so it does not fall over once the vacuum is on. Use a retort stand to do this. Once secured, you can put a rubber mat between your funnel and your flask to make sure it is sealed.
The filter medium chosen should be able to retain solid.
Filter medium is a permeable part of the filtration apparatus that separates a solid from a liquid.
Criteria for filter medium selection include surface area, porosity, and material of construction. Since the total volume of solution flowing through the filter medium is directly proportional to the surface area, the rate of filtration can be increased by using larger diameter filter media. And the porosity of a filter medium is responsible for the filtration rate and the retention ability of the filter medium. Vacuum filter funnels available with fine, medium, and coarse porosity. Filter funnels are manufactured from different materials such as porcelain, borosilicate glass, and plastic. Their specifications significantly depend on properties of materials funnels are made of. Porcelain designs are among the most common types of vacuum filter funnels because porcelain is resistant to chemical attack, easy to clean, and autoclavable. Borosilicate glass funnels with integral glass sintered discs are used in filtration of materials which attack paper. They are highly resistant to most corrosive reagents and do not require filter paper. Although porcelain and borosilicate designs are common, the trend of incrementing utilization of high-density polyethylene and polypropylene is keeping. This is because they have good features For example, they are non-breakable. There are many designs. Some are made of different plastic materials. For example, high-density polyethylene funnel with sealed-in polyethylene porous filter plate. And polypropylene funnel is made of two pieces of the same plastic material. Two-piece design makes it easy to clean. Some vacuum filter funnels have removable filter media. Common examples of this type of media are filter paper, plastic perforated filter plate, and fritted glass disc. Filter paper has properties such as porosity, particle retention, volumetric flow rate that allow it to be used for standard filtration, where the solutions are not particularly aggressive. Plastic, for example, high-density polyethylene perforated filter plate, is easy to clean or replace. Fritted glass disc with desired porosity is used where filter paper cannot withstand the chemical attack of the filtrate. Filter aid can be added to remove fine particles by vacuum filtration through pure light or sea light pad called pre-coat, made by building up a thin protective layer on the filter. Sea light diatomite is more chemically inert than perlite, and it is advantageous due to its high porosity and surface area. Perlite is a relatively pure volcanic rock. Although a flow through its bed is similar to flow through sea light bed, sea light is likely to be superior if maximum clarity is required. Now, we are ready to start collecting a solid by vacuum filtration. We need to select a suitable filter paper disc. There are many kinds of filter paper with different characteristics. Make sure you select the right one for your application. A filter paper disc should be small enough to remain flat, but large enough to cover all the holes in the bottom of the funnel. The edge of the disc should not extend up the sides. It's essential to wet the filter paper disc bedded into the funnel with small amount of an appropriate ice-cold solvent to create a seal between the paper disc and the funnel. Then we need to apply a gentle vacuum and check to make sure that air is being drawn through the paper disc. Before the paper dries, we need to start adding the mixture. After swirling gently mixture in the flask, pour the mixture down a clean glass rod aimed at the center of the filter medium to prevent splashing and spillage, while applying only a light vacuum until a protective layer of solid has built up on top of the paper disc to prevent paper from breakage. And it's better to add the mixture in small aliquots rather than one, so we can avoid overfilling. To transfer the remaining solid to the funnel, we are going to rinse out the flask with a minimum amount of cold solvent and pour the rinse into the funnel. And what we need to do next is to complete the transfer. We should scrub the remaining traces of the solid with either a policeman or a spatula from the inside of the flask, and then rinse off the last traces of solid both from the policeman and from the flask with a cold solvent into the filtering medium. Once all mother liquor has passed through the filter medium, we can start washing the solid in the funnel with the ice-cold solvent. We should reduce the vacuum and pour a small portion of our cold solvent onto the solid, and then add vacuum. Repeat this two more times to ensure all the impurities are removed. Dry by continuing to pull air through our solid product for about 10 minutes. If you don't use a trap, we should disconnect the tubing from the filter flask before turning off the vacuum. To transfer the solid product onto a watch glass, take the funnel off the filter flask, and then we can use either forceps or spatula to slide the filter paper onto the watch glass. Different methods can be used to dry the product. The choice of a suitable method depends upon the factors like chemical and physical properties of the product.